Hey guys, welcome to my latest video on a very, very important, crucial topic. No, it's not. It's just a silly little video. But I'm going to make this video about nictitating membranes. But before I go on, please remember to squish that subscribe button and pet the bell notification icon so that we can see more of each other. I'm just going to talk a little bit about cats' third eyelids. As many of you know, cats have this weird thing in their eye that we don't have. So let's count a cat's eyelids. This is Sir Lancelot, and he's kindly volunteered to be a cat today. One eyelid, that's the top eyelid. Second eyelid, that's the bottom eyelid. And see that white thing on the inside of his eye? That's a third eyelid that humans don't have, also called the nictitans or the nictitating membrane. Its job, just like the other two eyelids, is to clean the eye and distribute the tear film across it. Now, why do some animals have this and humans don't? I have no idea. But my theory is that it has a lot to do with being quadrupedal and not having these dexterous little fingers with which to clean out our eyes. It's probably also why cats have hairy little ears. See those lovely guard hairs on the ear? So these little membranes really vary between cats. Some will be very prominent, and in other cats you'll never ever see it, but they're always there. Some cats will even sleep with their first two eyelids wide open and the nictitating membrane like most of the way across. Super cute, looks kind of weird. And most of the time they don't cause any problems. Now, you can also have a lot of issues with nictitating membranes. In some cases, this is really rare, but and is more of a dog problem than a cat problem, but it does happen in cats. You can get foreign objects trapped underneath them, like a little grass seed is the most common one, and then it just kind of irritates the eye. Something, just a good thing for owners to be aware of. And when that happens, what do you see as an owner? Well, you see a squinty eye. And just as a public service announcement, a squinty eye is a painful eye. So anytime your pet squints at you with one eye, you should take them to the vet, without a doubt. Pretty much all the bad eye diseases show up as squinting. Now, having said that, sometimes cats will kind of lazily slow blink at you with one eye. If a cat's blinking at you, don't panic. That's basically a cat smile. But, you know, if an animal's there and there's one eye squinting, and especially if it's got discharge, that's probably a sign of discomfort. You should get it checked out. Back to the third eyelid. They have these little glands there that secrete a part of the tear film, and occasionally those glands will pop out, and that's called cherry eye. It's most commonly seen in puppies as a congenital disorder. If you look at this little third eyelid, I'm sorry, Lancelot, I know you just want to sleep, but I keep waking you up. If you look at this eyelid and you see kind of a red goober sticking out on the inside rim of that, and you have a young pet, it's probably cherry eye. Not a problem. Surgically, very easy to repair. Does require a little bit of eye surgery. About 70-80% success rate. Sometimes you have to do it twice, but yeah, very fixable. In an older pet, if you look at your pet and they have a little goober there, that could be a little bit more serious because you can get little tumors of those glands, and that's definitely cause for a vet visit. Well, all of this is cause for a vet visit. I'm just telling you what that vet visit may lead to. So that is the story with nictitating membranes. Very useful little things for cats. Super weird, in my opinion. Look at it go across. And occasionally they cause issues, but they solve more issues than they cause. Thank you for watching this very, very important and informative video.